is also.
Okay, that's what?
That's the challenge rhythm. And there's various ways of playing it, but it's also the rhythm that I would play primarily, especially for the first trimester. And then quicker for the second trimester, though I can vary it during the, I mean, third trimester, I can vary it for that, because the whole idea is to envision the kid doing this thing, feeling calm, feeling relaxed, feeling safe, and or feeling excited and ready to.
I love it.
And then I said, Bailly, which is probably the best formal 6-8 rhythm, because it transfers into jazz. When you use it, when they say play 6-8, the rhythm is probably going to be Bailly. Mm-hmm. Though often they'll play, like in African especially, they'll say play it in 6. It may be a 6-8 pulse, or it may not. And which is the same with the first pregnancy rhythm. It's a 6-8 pulse, but I mean, the rhythm is a 6-8, but it's a slower pulse than 6-8 itself. So when you're looking at drumming, you're looking at both musically, but you're looking at it aesthetically. And in other words, not necessarily exactly formalized music, or maybe very much formalized. You see my point?
Mm-hmm.
So when they say they want a certain, even 4, if they say they want a 4-4, you could play a basic 4-4, but they may be feeling something a little bit different.
Mm-hmm.
So you have to try to figure out what it is that they're feeling to give them the type of 4 that you have. And I do this in watching the dancers.
So you follow their lead, you don't set the tone or lead?
It's a combination of both. I mostly follow their lead.
Okay.
Because in my mind, I used to tell Cleo, dancers and drummers are supposed to be wedded. I'm not the only person that thinks that way.
Mm-hmm.
But almost like a psychic happening. Because the job of a drummer is, of course, to excite or to initiate the dancers or the audience. So we